today we're going to be focusing on deploying a Kubernetes cluster to the cloud. With any infrastructure as code, we probably want to start by creating a repository. So let's do that. So I'm going to actually go to the Alta4 LLC org. Example, AKS cluster. Example, Azure Kubernetes Service cluster. We're going to make it public because we are going to do it in Terraform. And we'll give this a good old-fashioned Apache license because that's the one I like. And we'll add a README file too. Sure, why not? Bam. As I said, with any infrastructure as code, you always got to start with code. The reality of it is you should have some type of repository or something like that. In this case, we're going to have an example AKS cluster. So let's go to our terminal. Okay, git clone like that. And we're going to clone our repository. So what do we want to do next? Well, there's a couple of things we want to do. We want to first make sure that we can communicate with Azure. So if I go here and then I do az --help, I should be able to see my Azure command works. There it is. And so you can see here, I have a whole bunch of Azure output. So I already have mine installed. So if I do az login and hit enter, it's going to kick open a new browser window for me. So if I go over here, there I am. So if I click on this, I can click my account and then you'll see, hey, you have logged into Microsoft Azure. Now, if I close this, right, and I go back here, well, there you go. Now, if you'll notice, I'm logged in. It says the cloud name is Azure Cloud. We've got my home tenant ID, and then we've got my username, right, which is my email and then my type. So the first thing we need is our example network. So here's where the fun part comes in. This is where we say, this is where we get to click. For anyone out there in the ClickOps world, this is where we get to have fun. So we're going to go into Azure and we're going to say, all right, well, I need to figure out how I create a network. Let's go to the ClickOps. So we're going to say virtual networks. Oh, there we go. Virtual networks. Now you'll see I've already got one here because we've got one for our company already set up, but maybe I don't know. And I'm curious. So I hit create. So we want to create a resource group and we want to create a resource group for our main objects of concerns or our main separations of concern. Those main separations of concerns are going to be the networking layer, the virtual machine, and then the Kubernetes stuff. So we're going to say that this is all going to be in a individual resource group. We're then going to say that everything related to the VMs is going to be related to a resource group besides the client. And then everything related to Kubernetes will be. So West US 3. Okay, cool. So let's just see this. Let's see if this works. So I'm going to just right quit and I'll say Terraform plan. Terraform apply. All right. We get asked if we want to apply it. We say yes. We should have a resource group created now in Azure. So we've got the resource group that we now need for all of our networking and all that stuff. So let's create the rest of the resources that we need. What we're going to want to do is we're going to want to create the network now. And then we're going to look at virtual network. They say we need a resource group. We've already done that. So we're going to do this. We're going to go back to our main file, right? And then we're just going to go under here and we're going to paste this. We can say that this is example network here. So we're just going to save that. This is our resource group. And actually what's really nice is if we click on example resource group here, we can see that in it is all of its resources. Or if we click on overview, we can see all the resources that are in it. And so if we look at the example network resource group, what do we have? Bam, our example network virtual network. If we go into Lucidchart, we then say that we need a VM subnet and a Kubernetes subnet. We actually just saw how we can add subnets by simply adding them here. Subnet, subnet. Look at what we've got. Resource group, virtual network, and then subnet. We've already created these two. So let's go ahead and create this next one. So we'll go back to our Terraform, paste in this. Cool. Okay. So this is one of our subnets. So here we go. So this is the module we want to use. All right. And as a matter of fact, I can just copy and paste this whole block. So we're going to go right underneath provider since this is kind of like a value. And then we're going to say we want a base cider block. So we're going to actually create a var as well. So we're going to say locals because this is a local variable. And we're going to say base cider block. And we're going to move what's down here on line 28, our base cider, put it right there, boop, right there. So we're going to follow with 10.0.0.16 as our base cider. And then we're going to use the subnet adders module in the HashiCorp subnet cider source, I guess, to generate these specific subnets for us. For this one, we'll change this to example virtual machine. It'll have 4 bits and then example Kubernetes. So what's happening with our Terraform, if we start from the top, is we're importing our Azure provider, and then we're configuring it optionally if we need to. We're then setting some local variables up. We're setting up a base cider block of 10.0.0.16, right? And then within that, we say we want to be able to generate a list of subnet addresses, essentially, from a base cider block that we predetermined in our locals values here. And then we want to generate this array of network. The first network we're going to generate is our example virtual machine network, and we're going to give it 4 new bits. For now, we're going to say example Kubernetes, and we're going to give it 4 new bits as well. So let's give this a shot. Let's see if this works. Might work, might not. Let's try a plan. There you go. You can see it's downloading the subnet cider. All right, so let's look here. What do we got? What do we got? We're creating 2 new subnets, right? First one, example Kubernetes, 10.0.16.20. Look at that. Just perfectly slices that subnet. Just perfectly divides it the way we need it to. 2 things we're gonna create here. We're gonna create our example Kubernetes subnet and our example virtual machine subnet. Everything looks good? Let's apply it and get these created. So I'm gonna hit yes. And as I said, we calculated these subnets using a module in Terraform. So I'm not telling it, oh, you need 10.0.16. I'm not spending time doing that. If we go back to our network and now we go to subnets, hey, there we go. Okay, so we've got an example virtual machine subnet and example Kubernetes subnet, 4.0.9.1 and 2.5.1. As we move forward, right, our Terraform is still very simple. Provider configuration, very simple locals configuration. We generate our subnets, we create our resource group, our virtual networks, and our subnets, right? So for 59 lines of code, we have quite a bit here already, which is fantastic. And so if we click on create, click on virtual machine. So we give it a virtual machine name, a region, availability options, availability zone, all pretty standard, security type, and then the size. So in this case, we're not gonna call it TwinGate. We're just gonna call it example bastion server. We're gonna get rid of this and we'll call it the same thing, right? Example bastion server. Resource group will be example virtual machine, resource group location, and then the admin username for now, we'll just say is example. All right, so we wanna create an Azure network interface now that we've created the main base basic blocks of our virtual machine. Our virtual machine is an example bastion server, example username. We give it the location of the resource group, the name that we want to give it, the network interface, which we'll give it in a second, as well as the size. And again, we want to give it just a very small burstable B1S just to save some money. We're going to say that our admin SSH key is the one. And here, we'll put some documentation here. We'll say created manually in Azure Portal and imported above, right? And so what we're going to do is we're gonna take this comment and we're gonna put it right there because I wanna make sure that if you guys use this, you're gonna have to create an example bastion server key right in the resource group and all that stuff essentially, right? Like you're gonna have to do the same thing here. So let's put this here as well and imported below. There we go. Okay, for now, we're just gonna say example bastion server. Resource group name is gonna be, right, our virtual machine dot name. Example virtual machine dot location. And then here's our IP configuration. We're gonna say that the name of this is going to be example bastion server. The subnet we want this to be on is our example virtual machine subnet, right? And we need to attach a public IP address. So now we're not done yet because now we need one more piece. And as a matter of fact, we already knew we needed this piece. So the piece that we actually did not include, now that we can add if we want, is a virtual network interface. We'll say that this network interface kind of exists like right here. So we need a public IP address now as well. So we're going to go back to here. And as I said, I've already got a lot of this written. So I'm going to just grab this public IP that we already had. And so we're going to put this right above it. We're going to uncomment it. And then we're going to replace anything that said TwinGate with example bastion server. And then our example virtual machine location. We want it to be a static IP address. So we're just gonna create a standard IP address. Now we have our public IP address. And so now this chart's really getting a lot more detailed where we can see, okay, well, the network interface sits basically between, you know, the virtual network and the public IP address. And the user connects to that public IP address, which then goes through the virtual interface to the jump box. So we need a way of telling the network interface, since this network, like this is our true firewall right here, guys. This network interface is the one true thing that people could connect over and have access to. So we want to make sure that we have our security group or our security rules on this set properly, because right now they're not allowing anything. We're going to want to actually create a network security group in general. So we're going to use my previous one as an example template. Right underneath network interface between public IP and network interface, we're going to paste our new security group rules. We're going to create a network interface security group association. This is what we're going to do to then connect our network interface on our Bastion server to the security group for it. Network interface example Bastion server, network security group example Bastion server. Right now, you could see that we're actually creating our virtual machine. Everything else seems to have been created. And let's go into the Azure portal. Let's click on virtual machines. And there it is. Look, example Bastion server, virtual machine, Alta 4 LLC, example virtual machine, West, US 3, standard. And bam, there's our IP address. We got our IP. And as a matter of fact, if I click on it, look at that. It's starting up. It's not ready yet, but we can see that it's running. Example virtual machine. It's all here. And there we go. If I refresh, bam, there we go. Green across the board. Heck yeah. It's up and running. It's in Azure. We've got three nodes. Boom. All done. All created.